Hey guys, welcome to Protocoders Point. Okay, so in this photo tutorial, we're gonna learn how to implement fingerprint scanner to authorize you to your photo application. So let's begin. So here I have just created a simple demo app just as an intro of this tutorial. So I'm not focusing on the UI part. So I have just created a button which pops up a dialog box so that a user can scan his fingerprint to get authorized to use the app. So let's scan my finger. So I'm scanning with a wrong index. So you can see there is an error. So I am just scanning now with the correct index. So you can see I got authorized to use this app and now I am in the welcome page. Okay, so let's learn how to implement it in your photo application. So let's begin. Okay, so now we are in our Android Studio and I have already created a new photo project by name Local Authentication Fingerprint in my Android Studio IDE. And in main.dartpage, for now we simply have an empty container in a home tag. Okay, so let's create a new page for authentication. So let's name it as auth path dot dart. Okay, so I will just work with the UI part quickly. So I will just fast forward the video over here. Okay, so I have just created a page where I am showing a text widget and a button to check the authentication. Okay, so when I press on this button, I want to show a dialog box to check authentication, something like this. You can see over here. So this is the button which invokes this authentication. Okay, so let's begin. Okay, so for fingerprint authentication, first of all, you need to add a dependency in your specification.yaml file under dependency section over here. So just add it. Okay, local authentication. After adding that, just hit this pubget button. Okay, so after adding that, you need to make some configuration. So let's check this out. So just go to pub.dev and over here you can search for local auth and you will get this library or a dependency. So here they have given how to use this package. Okay, so there are some configuration that needed to be done in Android and iOS devices. So let's do it. So you can see you need to change this code, that is main activity, and you need to add a fingerprint permission in your Android manifest. So let's do it. Okay, so I have already wrote an article on this, so you can just check this out for an easy understanding of this library. So link will be in the description, you just check it out. Okay, so let's do it. So first of all, let's add the permission in your Android folder. So go to Android, App, Sources, Main, Android Manifest, and over here in Manifest, after Manifest tag, over here you need to add this uses permission use fingerprint. Okay, so after adding that, you need to go to here in App, Sources, Main, Kotlin. If you are using Kotlin, you need to go to Kotlin folder and main activity, and under this main activity code you need to add this code. Okay, so you will just find this code in this library or in my website. So it's over here. Just use this if you are using Kotlin, and if you are using Java, then you can use this code. Okay, so let's add it, and there are three import statements you need to add. So these are the import statement you need to add, and you must make this activity Flutter activity to Flutter fragment activity, and that's it. Okay, so we are done with the Android part. So let's do this the same thing in iOS devices. So for iOS, go to iOS folder, runner, and you will see this info plist. So just open it, go to this article or this package library. So you just need to add this key and string. Okay, so you just add it over here. and that's it in iOS devices. Okay, so now let's go to our Flutter code main.dart, and from here I'm just calling this page to show the UI. So inside this we need to code, so let's begin. Okay, so here first of all you need to import our package that we have added, that is local auth. Over here, import local auth dot dart. Okay, so here we need to check if the your user device has a fingerprint scanner or no. So for that, let's do it now. So let's create a variable boolean has biometric sensor. Okay, so let's do it. So first of all, let's create an authentication object. Authentication is equal to local authentication. Okay, so here we'll just create one more method, a future method that will return if your device is having biometric sensor or no. So let's do it. Void check biometric sensor, make it asynchronous. Okay, so inside here we need to use try and catch block, try on catch platform exception. Okay, so if any platform exception is found in Android or iOS device, we will just catch it and print the error. So inside this try block, we need to check if the user device is having biometric sensor or no. So biometrics has biometric sensor is equal to await authentication, the object we have created above this one, dot check biometric sensor. Okay, so we need to give a question mark because of null safety. Okay, has biometric sensor or no, and we will just print the data that we have received, has biometric sensor. Okay, so let's call this method when the button is been pressed, the button we have created over here. So let's check it if it is working or no. So hot refresh. Okay, so now when I press on this button, so it should return me false or true. So it is not giving anything. Let me check. Okay, so I just made a mistake over here. Okay, so now hot refresh. So I'm just pressing on this button now. So there is no response. So let me force stop the app and restart it again. Okay, so app got restarted. So when I press on this button, so you can see it is getting true because my device has a biometric sensor. Okay, so now I just need to invoke a dialog box so that a user can scan his fingerprint. So for that, let's create one more function, future void get auth. Let's name the function, let's make it asynchronous, and inside here let's create a variable bool is authenticated is auth, and let's set it to false at the initial state. Okay, so let's use a try and catch block over here. So I will just copy this code. Okay, so inside this try block I need to code. So over here is auth is equal to await. Okay, await authentication object that we have created above dot authenticate, and over here you need to specify the reason why you want the fingerprint scanner to be used. So here you just need to pass a message to the user. So this is the message that will be shown to the user when the dialog appears. So here there are various properties that you can use. So biometric sensor. Okay, so biometric sensor we are going to use. So let's make it true. And if you don't use this, it will also use the face cam or biometric sensor both at once if needed. So in this tutorial we are going to just focus on biometric sensor. So I'm going to make it true over here. Okay, uses dialog, uses error dialog. So let's make this true. Okay, and sticky authentication will make it as true. Okay, so now let's print this message. Print authentication true or false. Okay, so I will just hot restart. Okay, sorry, I just forgot to call this method. So we will just call this method when user has a biometric sensor in his device. So after this is true, we will just call it. So for that, if has biometric sensor is true, if this is true, then we will just call this get authentication method. Okay, so let's hot restart again. Okay, so when I press on this button, so you can see a dialog box appears on our device screen. Okay, authorized. Okay, so now I just need to invoke this authentication immediately when the app restart, means when the user opens the app. So for that, in init method we can do it. So init state, over here we can just call this check biometric sensor. So in this biometric sensor, if we go, if the user has biometric sensor, then this method will get called automatically, and inside this method we are going to show this authentication dialog box. Okay, so now if the authentication is true, if the user authentication, if the fingerprint scan was successful, then this authentication variable will be true and this statement will work. Okay, so if the statement works, we need to navigate the user from authentication page to the welcome page, means the home page of our app. So let's create a home page. Okay, so now from here we need to call this home page. So let's do it by making use of navigation. Navigation dot replace, push replace, replacement, context, and the root. And for the root, we will make use of material root page root. Material page root builder. And we will just call our home page. Okay, so just import this page. Okay, so now if I refresh, hot refresh. Okay, so let's check the app. Hot refresh. So you can see hot refresh was applied and immediately this authentication page got opened. So now if I put a wrong finger, so it is showing not recognized. So now let's check with the correct finger. So you can see welcome to Protocoders Point. Please do subscribe Protocoders Point. Yeah. Okay, so that's all for this video tutorial. Hope you got the concept of how to implement fingerprint scanner in your Flutter application. Thanks for watching. Please do subscribe Protocoders Point. Thank you.